Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, how are you?
Hey, awesome man. How you doing?
Good, good, good. What's up?
Welcome to an episode of Ask Alec, man. You are on the show. What's going on? What's on your mind?
Oh, great. So it's about 3:30 a.m. here. I was just doing some late night grind.
You're awesome man. Thanks for
And
staying up. You're in India, right?
correct. Yep.
Awesome. A lot of readers out in India. I was there for a poker
You were there
tour,
last year
yeah,
for
in
the
poker sports
BSL.
league, yeah, PSL. That was awesome.
Right.
So it was cool. Goa was an experience for sure. So anyway,
Oh,
man,
that's
what's
lovely.
up? What's on your mind?
So yeah, I mean, I want to ask you a question. We as poker players, we would travel a lot. I've seen your vlogs, I've seen your stories, you travel a lot. So
Yes.
basically it comes from there. How do you manage your gym routine, your diet, your study schedule and your sleep schedule when you're on such travels? Because they kind of get messed up when you're out of your box, when you're out of your base, right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of a tough thing to go around.
So like one thing I so for me it's about engineering the ideal day. And I know that like for me I'm not gonna just like have a good day if I leave it up to chance. And so there's certain things that I believe you can do every single day that are gonna make you feel great, perform better, be in peak performance mode. And I usually do these, I obviously always do these things when I'm in poker mode, when I'm playing poker for that day to make sure I'm engineering that day. But also, like, these would just become how I want to feel on a daily basis. So even when I'm not playing poker, or if I don't play poker for the day, even if I'm just working, or I'm traveling, or I'm going out for the day on a hike with my wife, like, I still want to feel that peak performance mode that I feel when I play poker because that's my best self. And so I really, it's important to learn this skill set for the road because, like you said, like a lot of times you're traveling, and a lot of times when you are traveling, you're traveling for business or you're traveling to play poker. And so it's even more important that you bring these elements with you while you're traveling. But the first sort of perspective shift I want to give everyone is that it's really about thinking through your days like in terms of engineering them to be in a certain state of mind or in a certain way that you're going to feel and perform. And that sort of mental place is where I want people to go first and foremost. Just start to think about their days like which things are triggers for either taking you closer to feeling your best and performing your best, or things that are triggers from making you further away from that goal of yours. For example, and we'll talk about specifics in a second, but one example is obviously like what you eat. So if I'm sitting down for a meal and it's lunchtime, I'm thinking about, how is what I eat now going to affect not just how I look in the future or whatever, something superficial, but how is it going to immediately affect how I feel in 30 minutes? And so I'm always going through this process of reverse engineering how I want my outcome to be, and then giving myself certain inputs for sleep, for exercise, for diet, for lifestyle, for meditation, whatever it is, to achieve a certain result. And that's kind of like the mental process that I'm going through. And so for me on vacation specifically, my routine isn't really any different than it is at home. And what I mean by that is when you look at the elements that engineer peak performance, there's certain basic things everyone can do to feel better, to perform better, and it doesn't really change whether you're at home or on vacation. For example, exercise is one thing that helps. Now, whether you're on vacation or whether you're at home, what might change is the type of exercise that you do. And without getting too much into specifics of like which exercise is the
Right.
best for peak performance, it doesn't really matter that much. We're talking about pushing inches. The difference between not exercising and exercising is, let's say that's a 10. The difference between what exercise you do is micro. And so my whole thing is when I'm on vacation, like at the worst case scenario, I'll get up, I'll go outside and I'll go on a run for 30 minutes. Because that's going to release endorphins and make me feel good, and I'll get that exercise in. If I'm at home, I
I
could be.
think when you win, I'll just say something here. I think when you said it's about engineering your whole routine, I think it's about your mind and body connection, right? And when you said that, I just got back to my last trip where I didn't have a gym, but yeah, I had a swimming pool. So instead of going to the gym, I actually went for a swim those two and three days, right? So yes. That was kind of good for me because it got my body into shape and just set my mind for the game, you know?
Totally. So I've written a blog about this on alectrelli.com called the 10 best tips for a morning routine, like 10 best ways to have a perfect day, something like that. I'll link it below this video. But basically, you know, going through the process, it's like checking the boxes of things that I know, even if I don't emotionally feel like doing them. Because a lot of times emotionally, I don't feel like going through the motions. Like I get up, I don't feel like working out. I don't feel like eating what I need to eat to be in my best shape. I don't feel like meditating or journaling. But I know that at the end of that tunnel, if I go through the process, I'm going to feel amazing. I'm going to perform amazing. And so really what I'm doing is I'm architecting my day and I'm writing down everything I want to do and then checking the boxes. So the first thing I do when I get up, I'll have hot water with lemon, just something to like detox my body, get some fluid inside of me, some liquid. I'll drink like as much water as I can, like literally a thermos full, like something like this, and I'll just sip on that. I'll do some journaling in something simple called the 5-minute journal. I'll meditate for 15-20 minutes, and then I'll immediately do cardio on an empty stomach. This not only burns fat and gets my heart rate up, but it's I feel like the best way to wake up the body. So I'll do, you know, a 20-minute run on an empty stomach, and then I will have a light breakfast, something like a green smoothie or like a green tea with some coconut oil, some healthy fat with like some caffeine, some combination of something like that. And then really it's like after that, I'm feeling really good. Like that's, you know, five things you could do right there in the morning that you're going to feel pretty damn good. And if you could check all those boxes, and, you know, I could get all this done in the first hour of my day. You know, get up, 15 minutes of journaling, 15 minutes of meditation, 30 minutes of working out. Breakfast takes 5 minutes, 10 minutes at the most. An hour, hour and a half into my day, I'm pretty much done with my routine that's going to make sure I'm feeling great. And then it's about just maintaining that road that I've built for myself. So I've already set myself up to go north on my trajectory for the day when I get up. Like I'm already going directly to where I want to go, which means I'm going to perform and feel my best. And then it's just about eating correctly the rest of the day to make sure I'm eating less than I think I need to, because whenever I don't eat a lot, I feel great. So always being lighter than I need to. When you eat a lot of food, your body has to digest that, and then you know you get heavy and you get tired. So if I skip meals or fast or have very little to eat, I feel great. And so the rest of the day, it's just about going through that process. But like on vacation, I mean, if you stay at a hotel, they have a gym. It's just about, sometimes it's as simple as writing out what you want to do during the day, the night before, and writing times that you're going to do that. So 8 a.m., get up. 8:15, meditate. 8:30, exercise. 9 o'clock, breakfast. And then, you know, from 8 to 9:30, you're kind of checking those boxes, engineering that great day that you want to have. And by 9:30, you can hang around the hotel, go out for the day, or do whatever you're doing on vacation. Go play poker, whatever. It could be 10 to 11:30. The time doesn't matter. But the point being that you need to like take the same precautions that you would take in your daily life at home. And so I travel with the 5-minute journal. It's literally like a journal that I travel with where I write down things every day that I want to accomplish. I literally travel with that. I will sometimes travel with like matcha green tea powder because I like to have my matcha in the morning. I will travel with like energy or power bars that have no sugar, that are like, you know, clean protein bars, so I can eat healthy while I'm on the go. Like I'll have things that I'll travel with that help too. Maybe it's even something like a foam roller or a resistance band where I can do a little bit of strength training. If I'm seriously somewhere where all I'm going to be able to do is run, I'll bring some resistance bands or whatever, you know, a foam roller. And so I could like stretch out, do some yoga and whatever. Like I'll just get it done. Like honestly, even on the internet, you could do so many great workouts through YouTube or like I forgot like a website called like Booyah Fitness that I used to join, where they have like workouts that are CrossFit style with that only use your body weight, that are 20-30 minutes, okay, that kick your ass. Like, it's just about planning ahead of time. So like not going to the hotel feeling like you're going to leave it up to chance, but going there first and foremost with that mentality of, you know, every day I'm going to engineer to feel amazing and to perform my best, and then understanding what it's going to take to do that, and then backing that up by planning ahead, like bringing things that are going to help you achieve your goals, and maybe even writing out what you're going to do on a given day so that you feel, you know, you achieve what you want.
Wow, that was great. I mean, a lot of takeaways from there.
Yeah, thank you.
I think I have three to four points on the top of my mind right now, you know, from these what you just said, and I think I'm just going to implement this my next trip, which is maybe next week, you know.
Yeah, for sure. And this sort of came out of necessity for me. Like, I travel, you know, a couple hundred days a year. I'm always on the road. For like 8 years, I didn't have a home. I was just living wherever I was. And so I got efficient at working out in unique environments. And what I noticed was that it didn't really matter what environment I was in. As long as I was checking, you know, 5 or 6 boxes every day, it didn't really matter that much whether I did CrossFit or, you know, strength training, or I went on a run, or I did swimming. Like, sure, there's workouts that I prefer. There's things that I prefer to do. But at the end of the day, if I check the boxes, I'm going to feel 90% of what I would feel otherwise, you know? And so I push myself hard and I just make sure that I get through everything. And I also don't allow myself to really like eat in the morning until I've gotten my run in, so that, you know, I'm always going through those motions of knowing that I'm going to feel good in an hour and a half. And the way I see it is like, look, I'm awake for 16 hours. I'm going to invest an hour or an hour and a half of those 16 to feel good for 14 and a half. You know, so I don't really like the first hour of my day a lot of times. Like, I don't really want necessarily to meditate. Like, consciously, you're kind of like, you know, this is going to be boring. I'm going to be frustrated. I'm going to be like, I don't really want to go on a run because I'm going to be tired. It's like, I'm on an empty stomach. I have to push myself. Like, you know, you don't really necessarily emotionally want to do these things. Sometimes for breakfast, I mean, I try not to eat sugar, so I don't really crave high glycemic foods, but sometimes I'm craving other foods that I want to eat, but I know if I eat this, I'm going to feel better. And so I really just go through the motions. I don't really listen to my emotional circuit, and I just force myself to do things. And that's why I find, for me, you know, writing it out sometimes helps, because then you don't really leave it to chance. You're not really leaving it to emotions. You're just following what you wrote out for yourself. So I think that helps too.
I'll take this as 2 points, right? One is you train your mind to train your body to have peak performance during the day.
Absolutely.
And the second thing is you invest those 1.5 hour, 2 hours initially, so that you realize your entire 14 hours of value during the day, right?
It's a great trade. You're trading 1 hour for 15.
Perfect, yep.
You know, and it's like, it's a no-brainer. You're investing, you know, 6% of your day, 5%, 7%, 10% of your day to, you know, for the rest of the 90% or the 95%. So it's a no-brainer trade. Yep. And when you think about it like that, it really inspires me to go on that run first thing in the morning, because I'm like, I'm going to feel amazing. Not let alone all the other benefits of doing this, right? Like, you're going to live longer, you're going to be skinnier, your body's going to function better, you're going to have less disease, like all the other obvious health benefits that we didn't even discuss. I'm strictly talking about peak performance and how I feel immediately that day, not how I'm going to feel or perform when I'm 65, as opposed, you know what I mean? I'm talking about immediate gratification, right? Of, I literally notice cognitive benefits within like 2 hours of doing this, of 2 hours of when I get up, and I could either go left or right, and there's a huge difference in how I feel depending on those first hour and a half of my day. And look, once you invest an hour and a half of your day, the first hour and a half, to go down a certain path, it's easy to eat healthy for lunch because you already sacrificed breakfast. You already sacrificed, you know, doing something in the morning that's going to empower you. You already went on a run. you know, you already have momentum. So it's easy to keep the momentum, which is why I didn't even really talk about lunch or dinner or what I do the rest of the day, because once you build that momentum, you're going to be going down this trajectory of healthy, conscious, healthy eating, conscious, healthy living the rest of the day. And then it's about optimizing the rest of the day and figuring out what works for you individually. But it's really about starting with the morning. That first hour is where you set the tone for the next 15.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, correct. I get this. It's wonderful to hear this viewpoint of yours.
Awesome, man. Thank you for your time today. I appreciate you joining the show. I hope you had some great takeaways from this.
Thanks.
I hope you guys like this episode.
Take care. Bye.
Thanks a lot, man. See ya. Thanks for your time. Cheers. Guys, that's it for Ask Alec. You keep asking questions. I will keep answering them. If you have questions, leave them below this video. Reach out to me, consciouspoker.com. You can get in touch with me, and I'll pick the best questions, get in touch with you guys, and host awesome questions here on this channel. Thank you for so much for your time. You guys are awesome. And subscribe to my channel if you like this. More great content coming your way. Share this with someone that you think would benefit. You guys are legends. Much love. Peace, everybody.